Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and to the series on marriage and sparking romance. This video is particularly on sparking excitement in your marriage. And all of these videos in this series are science and research-backed ways to build a better bond with your spouse. It came from a place of wanting to learn myself about this very thing. Like, what does science have to say about how we bond with another person? Can we actually be proactive and intentional about growing in romance with our spouses? Because sometimes we think romance is just a thing that happens on its own and it doesn't take any kind of kindling or, you know, stoking the fire on our part. But I have a theory that if we are intentional about our relationships, like, we can have a thriving relationship. We don't have to be passive to think, oh well, I guess, you know, our love is cooling, or maybe we've hit a rough patch or something, and you're just kind of just letting things happen as they happen. Well, in some ways I'm a go with the flow kind of gal. In this regard, when it comes to relationships and things that really matter, I like to be more intentional about it. So that's where all of this came from. And now we're gonna get right into how to spark excitement in your marriage. So excitement naturally happens at the beginning of a relationship. There is so much new going on. You know, you see a guy, you're attracted to him, that attraction builds. And then there's the excitement of, like, hearing from them, like from a text or an email or a call, or going out on a date and doing things and having that love blossom, the thrill of falling in love. It's mysterious, it's wonderful, but it doesn't last. So when you get married to somebody, you start to cohabitate and you start to see their dirty laundry or their quirks or, you know, different things like that. You become super familiar with the person, which is awesome, and there's a beautiful intimacy in that as well. But if you feel like, oh, where was the spark when we first got married? It's totally natural that that kind of mellows out a little bit. I mean, we have to make decisions together now, and especially if you're having children now, you know, there's a shared responsibility, the joy of it, the beauty of it. But maybe you're just thinking, oh, I kind of miss the butterflies and the spark and all of that. Well, research suggests actually something really encouraging in this regard. So if you're feeling like you need some excitement and spark in your marriage again, you can actually build that intentionally in some pretty fun ways. So studies have shown that while in the beginning of your relationship, the source of excitement is one another in that new blossoming relationship that's happening, as you deepen your relationship and grow closer and more familiar, you can build that spark again by looking outside of each other, actually, and going forward into excitement through exciting experiences. So there were a couple of articles on this that said no more boring dates. Like, you need to stop having these nicey-nicey dates of a romantic dinner. And they suggested instead that you do something that's exciting and thrilling, that gets your adrenaline pumping, that boosts your anticipation and stuff like that. So that could be things like travel, that could be things like taking dance lessons together, that could be watching a thrilling movie together, that could be gaming together, that could be whitewater rafting or zip lining or adventure sporting. Something that really just gives you that rush of excitement. And what happens in our brains when we do these exciting activities with our spouses is that we connect that excitement that we're feeling through the experience with the person we're doing it with. So that actually generates things like butterflies and that spark we were feeling at the very beginning when we first fell in love. So if you're wanting to spark some excitement in your marriage, maybe you can talk with your spouse about some exciting out of the ordinary date ideas and make it happen and then just see what happens. I'd be really curious to know that if you give it a go and you do something that is thrilling and exciting, maybe even a little bit scary, how that makes you build a better bond, how that made you feel excited again in your marriage. Well, I hope you enjoyed this little tip on how to spark excitement in your marriage, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Bye.